This guy drove me crazy when he came in. I'm working. It's a busy Saturday. I saw him coming by ambulance. Chief complaint is I'm weak. 55-year-old guy who's weak. And I'm like, that's a crappy complaint, right? So he comes in, and I remember our eyes made contact, and he went, and he waved at me, and I was really unhappy with this. Like, I really thought there was manipulation, secondary gain going on. And I went in the room, sir, what's going on? He says, I'm just weak. And I said, you're just weak. Yeah, I can't get off the couch. And I expected him to say, and I need a note for work, right? I expected this to be some lingering. I just didn't, I had tremendous contempt prior to investigation. Well, he says, well, when I take a step, I get short of breath. So I started this cardiac workup, and I do this EKG, and as I look at the EKG, he's not on any medicines, no past medical history. He said he hasn't seen a doc in 10 years, though. So I look at the EKG, and I see it looks like there's some elevations in the inferior leads, 2-3 AVF, and I'm like, that doesn't make any sense. He had no anginal equivalent whatsoever. And then I look at the reciprocal changes, 1 AVL, and I'm going, boy, this sure looks consistent with elevations in the inferior leads with reciprocal changes. And then I'm thinking, wait a second, as some of you folks have pointed out on this Facebook page, if it's the inferior wall, then it would be the right coronary artery, which would feed the AV node. And if the AV node is ischemic, they're classically bradycardic, and his heart rate was 45. I mean, all of this pointed to a STEMI, an inferior wall STEMI. Didn't make sense, though. He had no symptoms. So I asked the nurse's aide, as we're waiting for the lab test to come back, I said, what patients present with silent MIs? What patients present with silent MIs? And I remember a point that I teach at all my life conferences. I believe that diabetics were put on this earth to burn us. And I had them check a blood sugar, and indeed he was an undiagnosed diabetic. So his blood sugar was in the 300 range. Troponin came back at 8. And we treated him with antiplatelets, heparin, and because he has Q wave formation, ladies and gentlemen, look at the inferior leads on the EKG. You see big fat Q waves. If you look at the inferior wall, ladies and gentlemen, 2-3 AVF, you see Q waves, which means he already scarred out his inferior wall. I mean, the elevations tell me there's still damage going on, but the damage is done. So he's not a thrombolytic candidate. Remember that thrombolytics are indicated if you catch them within the first 12 hours, and he is saying his symptoms have been going on for 3 days. So I called cardiology, we shipped him down, and of interest, notice the heart block. He's got a Mobitz 2 there, right? He's got a Mobitz 2 heart block. He's got non-conducted P waves. You can see him predominantly in 1 and AVL. So this was an interesting case of a silent MI. My teaching point of this case is that risk factor analysis. You always have to think of risk factors. Now, what are the cardiac risk factors? SAD, CHF, smoking, age, diabetes, cholesterol, hypertension, family history. Diabetics were put on this earth to burn us. Hey folks, John Blitzky here from See Me for Life. Our whole goal is to help you maximize your mind. If any of these case studies are working for you, please teach others. Apply this, make a difference to patients' lives. Thanks for watching.